Welcome to a tutorial on how ChatGPT can help you with email marketing. ChatGPT is a powerful tool that not only allows you to create personalized and engaging email campaigns, but it can also help you with writing the emails. With ChatGPT, you can easily generate email copy and ideas for your campaigns. To get started with ChatGPT, sign up for an account on the ChatGPT website and access the email marketing features by clicking on the email tab in the main menu. One way ChatGPT can assist you with email marketing is by helping you write effective email copy. To do this, simply enter a prompt into ChatGPT, such as write a subject line for an email promoting a sale at a clothing store, and ChatGPT will then generate a list of suggestions for you to choose from. ChatGPT can also help you come up with ideas for your email campaigns. For example, you can enter a prompt like brainstorm ideas for an email campaign promoting a new product launch. ChatGPT will then generate a list of creative and unique ideas for you to consider. In addition to helping you with the writing and ideation process, ChatGPT also has all the features you need to create and send professional email campaigns. You can easily design email templates, build your email list, and track the effectiveness of your campaigns using ChatGPT's analytics dashboard. So next time you're struggling to come up with email copy or ideas, try using ChatGPT to help you create engaging and successful email campaigns. Okay, so if you didn't catch on, everything that I've read up to this point was a script. And it was a script that I had written by AI, by ChatGPT. So you've probably heard of ChatGPT. It's been the biggest hyped up thing in the marketing world over the last month. And I wanted to give my take on, okay, what can we do? Is this actually useful? Can we use this for email marketing? And how would I recommend using this for email marketing? So if you don't know ChatGPT, if you go to chat.openai.com, it's an artificial intelligence that you can actually chat with, and you can have it, you know, write a blog post for you, write an email for you, write a paper for school for you, and you can just ask it questions and it will give you information based on whatever you ask. And it's surprisingly good as far as like the quality of information that it provides is surprisingly good. So the big thing now is that, you know, a lot of content marketers are planning to use this to just pump out massive amounts of content for their businesses. And you might be thinking or wondering if you should do the same. So I actually don't think that it's as good as people are making it out to be, personally, having played around with it. So for one thing, with that script that I just read off, some of the information in there was actually wrong as far as being able to create all your emails and log, you know, and generate leads and all this stuff through ChatGPT, and the way it described like where to get to that function in their website, just none of that was correct at all. I'm not sure where it even got that from. And the other thing is I had to go through a couple of rounds of revision to even get to that version of the script. But that brings me to where it's actually useful. So if you're going to completely rely on this to write copy for you, it's probably not going to take you very far, because for one, the copy is just okay. It's not great. And the other thing is that Google, or I should say Gmail specifically, Google's working on filters to be able to filter out AI generated copy and send it to spam. So even if you can get away with it for a while, it likely won't last long, and it might end up doing more damage than it's worth to your reputation as an email sender. So if you were only sending AI generated copy, I definitely would not recommend it. What I would recommend as far as getting the copy is to have it write copy and then have it go through a couple of rounds of revision. So maybe, so, you know, you would tell it specific, give it specific feedback for how to revise it. And it does tend to get better and better, but then you would still want to manually have a human edit the copy after that. Now, and another thing is whenever you're having it write emails for you, the bigger the brand is that it's writing copy for, meaning that the more information there is online, the better it's going to do without you having to provide as much information to it. But again, the copy always kind of ends up, I would say for the most part, it ends up factually correct. It's just boring. It's just, you know, not very good copy. It's not using principles of influence and trying to persuade the person who's reading the email. But where I think it actually is pretty useful is for generating email ideas. So if you're just totally, you know, looking at a blank slate and your mind's just not coming up with any ideas, you could go in there, ask it to generate some ideas. It'll spit out 10 ideas and you could say, okay, those are good, but can you give me 10 more that are more specific to this thing or whatever? And you can get to where you get a lot of ideas, and then you can take that idea. And again, you can have it write some copy for a specific topic and maybe do a couple of revisions. And this might give you some ideas of angles to take, but I wouldn't rely on that alone. And I also found that even the ideas it generates for someone who has no idea what they're doing with email marketing, yeah, they might think, oh, wow, these are a bunch of like really cool, unique ideas. But if you have been doing it for a while and you probably already have a collection of ideas and marketing angles and topics that you've done in the past, and I find most of them what it spits out to be very, you know, elementary, and it's just kind of like the obvious stuff that you probably would have already figured out. So I don't personally find this to be that much more useful than the previous AI software that's already available when it comes to, you know, writing the copy for your emails and generating ideas. But for someone who's never used these before, it's probably going to be a lot of fun for you to play around with. And for someone who, if you're just getting started with email marketing, it actually can provide you a lot of great ideas, because you might just not know where to start. And it will give you some good ideas. It's just that the best ideas you will be able to use quickly, and then what? Then you need to come up with more ideas. So I think this is going to be useful as, you know, brainstorming and also maybe getting started with copy, but I personally would not rely on this completely. At least we're just not to that point yet. And that's kind of how it's been with the previous AI software that's out there, where it's pretty good and it can definitely help you generate ideas. It's really great for getting you started. So instead of just looking at a blank canvas, it actually gets some words on the screen to get some momentum going. But you really do want to step in and edit it manually, for one, to avoid being labeled as spam, but two, you actually want to add some personality in there and you know, really customize it for the product or for the company that the copy is written for. But yeah, it can definitely be useful. So I think that the hype is overblown. I don't think it's going to, you know, massively change anything over the next year, but I definitely think that if it continues to improve the way that AI has improved so far, that we could see where we don't have to create emails at all manually in 10 years, and we would have software just doing all of that for us, just writing all of the copy, doing all of the designs, constantly A/B testing, you know, between, you know, millions of people who are receiving these emails, or billions of people who are receiving these emails, or emails that go out, and being able to iterate on that. I can definitely see that in the future we won't even have to create them at all, but we are not there yet. So if this is something where you're looking to totally lean on this, I would again at least use the safety precaution of editing your content, just to make sure you don't get punished in the future for using AI generated content. But other than that, I think it's a great brainstorming tool, and I think it can be very useful for that. And that's what I would recommend using it for when it comes to email marketing. So I know everyone's hopping on, the trend of talking about this potential chat, and you know, we could go on and on about all of the implications of what this means for the future and the types of businesses that this will create and replace and all of that. And I definitely believe all of that. But when it comes to use case for email marketing specifically in the next 3 to 6 months, it's a lot of hype and it's not quite as great as you might think, which means there's still the pressure on us to do good work as email marketers. And I still have a job for another day. So that's it for this video. And if there's anything else that comes up like this, any trending items, anything that's getting a lot of hype, and you want to hear from someone who's actually tested it and implemented it and get some feedback, then leave a comment in the video, and I'll do some more videos on those topics. So that's it for this one, and I will see you in the next video.